Hello, everyone. I'm Katharsus, and welcome back to Conan Exiles. We're going to do some base building today. We started a little bit on our base in the last video. Oops, probably shouldn't back off that ledge. We started a little bit on some base building in our last video, but I didn't get a ton done. We just kind of got sort of like this tower that I was building over here, and actually I've now finished a platform at the top, which is where I'm going to build my actual base itself, and I'll kind of give you a little walk-down tour to give you an idea of what it looks like. I'm kind of envisioning something that's maybe a little bit like sort of like a shogun kind of castle temple sort of thing. I don't know how well I'm going to be able to build it out, but that's kind of what I want to go for. You can see across the way, if I can get close enough here and get the load distance in, there's somebody that's actually built, they built a base just over on, there it is there, it's just loading in. They built a base just behind that other statue, and they've got it creeping all the way up to the top, which is pretty cool. There have been some really cool builds that people have put up online as well that that looked really impressive, but hopefully this one will turn out well. So this this upper level here is where the actual base is going to be. I'm going to just turn this into a big building. I'm thinking maybe three or four floors tops. I mean, it's only me, so I don't need like a super huge place, even if at some point we end up getting like a tribe or a clan or whatever they call it in this game. It should give us plenty of room to work with, at least, particularly since I'm kind of planning to have a compound down below still. So this is the lower level, and it goes all the way around this this little mountain peak kind of thing I built on. And then over here, I'm going to have to redesign the tower a little bit. This basically just connects down to the tower. And the cool thing about this is that if I want to cut myself off at night, I can actually just go up to the top here and destroy the top staircase. And then people can't reach up into my base from there because they can't build on my land, I don't think. And that will kind of give me the ability to sort of cut my castle off, so I don't have to worry about, like, if I'm offline, people doing any kind of raiding or that sort of thing. So down the tower, this is what we built last time. I kind of did a little experimenting to see how the walls were going to work out here, because I want to do a walled compound. I did use the foundation stones here for the wall foundation, but they have to go in a really straight line. So it's either they go straight out or they go perpendicular, cutting across like a T-intersection on the wall. So I'm not sure how well these are going to work. I'm kind of thinking that maybe foundations might make a better way to build, because with the foundations you can do the triangular pieces. They'll give us the ability to kind of turn the wall on an angle so I can kind of get it to go the direction I want. Plus with the foundations, I can also raise up this portion down here so that it's not sunken down so far, and I can have a relatively flat space. But I'm thinking I'm going to put the wall maybe somewhere out to like here kind of thing, and it'll run along this way. And then over here, it'll cut back and go towards the wall. So not too big of a walled compound, just a little one. And then later on, if we want to expand it, we can. But the actual building that I'm making up top, actually, I think it looks pretty cool so far on top of the mountain. It's kind of, I did a lot of harvesting to get the resources to be able to build this out so far. I put a ton of stone into the foundation, so you can see many of them are stretching up there. Most of those foundation stones are up there are really just for aesthetics. They don't really hold anything up. The ones that are closer to the top certainly do, because they support the actual floor pieces, but the ones that are down lower are really just kind of there for looks. So that's how it's going to look. I think on that lower level is where I can put like archers and things to kind of defend it a little bit. I'm not sure that they're going to be able to shoot down very well from that height. I'll have to see. If it doesn't work out too well, then maybe I can put something down lower here. But let's go back up top. I want to start building on the actual house itself today. I did do a whole bunch of resource gathering to build out some walls and some floor pieces and that kind of thing. But we'll pop back up and do that, and then I think once we run out of the building pieces, I may only get maybe one, possibly two levels done before I run out of pieces. Then I would like to go do a little bit of exploring. I could use some coal in particular. Oh, this is a little sidewall I put in here between the one tower and the next. So, I mean, if I had my bow, then I could actually shoot over top of this if I wanted to. I'm kind of thinking that maybe the foundations might be good for that around the outside also, because I don't have to do like a walkway or anything. I can actually just have them run right across the top of the foundation. And I can put some archers and stuff up there too, which would be good. So we'll pop back up top here and then keep building. All right, since we're going to be building at the sort of a peak up here, we don't really have to worry too much about walls and doors. I really just want to focus on the exterior wall and then the ceilings and stuff on the interior, and then some stairways up and that sort of thing. So I've got a ton of materials that I've put aside here and this little bin. I'm not sure how much of them I can carry at once. I'm going to find out in a second. Apparently that is too many. So let's try to split that if we can. And then we can put half of those back for now. I'm going to get rid of all the stuff here that I don't need to carry that's going to potentially add to my weight. Same thing here. Oh, 103%. If we get rid of this wood, I think we'll be good. 99. There we go. All right. So I have some window walls, and I have some regular walls. And we're going to have to kind of space these out a little bit. So this square up top here is seven pieces by seven pieces. So I do know that at least I have a consistent middle. So I'm thinking like one, two, three. So on four here, I think I'm going to put... There we go. So in the middle on each side, I'm going to put just a regular wall piece. And then this one will actually be right above the stairs over here. There we go. And then either side of that, I'm going to put windows. I think I might even do... Yeah, I'm going to do two windows on each side. Like so. And then the very corner pieces will just be regular wall pieces. So this will give me the ability to kind of go up and look out at least a little bit. As on the higher levels of this castle thing, I'm going to want to try and do probably some sort of a balcony kind of thing too, so you can actually walk out and check things out. You won't be able to see straight down because the castle itself will get in the way. I think as we build up levels, I'll probably tier this a little bit. But at least it'll give you that view so you can kind of see out over the distance. I think I have enough pieces to build this whole bottom level, and that's pretty much gonna cap us off. Because I don't want this to be only a single wall high. I want it to be two walls high. And on the upper wall, I don't need windows because it's too high for me to see out of anyway. All right, there we go. So we've got, aside from those two little corners there, we pretty much have the whole top floor all sealed off now. Oh, gotta watch where I'm walking. All right, I just ran out of walls. So in here I have, unfortunately I have more of those. This might actually be pushing it. I may not actually have enough to get this whole thing sealed off at two walls high. It's gonna be a little bit close. It takes so long to gather materials when you're just using a plain stone pickaxe too. I think in addition to finding some coal, I would really like to find some metal. I do have some metal resources, but I don't have any kind of a blacksmith or anything yet, so I can't do anything with it. But ultimately, I will be able to. Okay, so we've got... Oops, don't need that. We've got that bottom level done now. I'm going to put these back in the chest, and we'll take out some flooring pieces and some stair array. And I do have more stone in here, so I can make more stuff if I need to, but hopefully... This will give us enough at least to get things started. Okay, so I need to figure out where I want my stairs to be positioned. So as you come out this way and you come up, I'm kind of thinking maybe something over here. Going upward. And then on the next level up, so you kind of crisscross back and forth as you go up levels. Maybe? Okay, kind of what I'm thinking. So I only have two stairs right now, so we'll put the first one here. Second one can go here. Now the trick is going to be, I'm not sure whether this will let me actually support a ceiling that's this open. I may have to put some pillars in this lower area here. But we'll cross that bridge when we get to it, I guess. Oh, I just totally wasted one. I wish there was some sort of, like, buyer's remorse period when you put these things down. Like, you can put it down and... If you don't stick it in the wrong place or something, then you can take it back without a cost. A couple times when you're building this, you might find that the pieces just fail to place. You get this area that says fail to place building. All you have to do is just rotate the piece, and then it goes down. I don't know what that is. It's some sort of a weird bug. Okay, I don't need to fill in the stairs, naturally. Nope. What are we lacking on? Water. And I should probably eat here quickly, too. There we go. I'm kind of hoping I can get some sort of a well or something up here. So, oh yeah, it looks like I can't place into this open space in the middle. I can get pretty far. just not quite out to the very center. In some ways, that might actually be preferable. I guess I could do it almost like a the old murder hole concept, where I could have guards up here so that if somebody gets down into that lower level, they can shoot down at them through this opening in the middle. Actually, I do think I kind of like that opening there. I'm going to leave that. Maybe I might even put a little fence around it or something, but I think I kind of like that opening. So there's, I have some roofing pieces in here. Because I want to make something that looks a little bit like sort of a Japanese castle, they've got, on the outside of the Japanese castles, they have this, like, I don't know how to describe it. It's like a sloping wall. There's a sloping roof piece, rather. I don't know if this is going to let me do it, though. It seems to want to angle upwards, and I need it to angle downwards. So it kind of hangs out over the space instead of anchoring at the bottom here. I want it to anchor at the top and be kind of hanging down over the side. Oh, there we go. Now, hopefully, it'll be easier to snap pieces now that I've got one there. Nope. Not going to cooperate. Come on. I don't know how slippery these are if I walk on them. No, okay, I can walk on it. Nice. Okay, if I can get it down here, facing outwards, then I can rotate it and it goes into place. Okay. This is going to be a bit finicky, but I'm going to do this kind of around the whole outside of this one level. Come on. And then once we have this all the way around, I do actually want to do some corner pieces, but I don't know if I have enough materials to do it yet. I'll have to see if that's going to how that's going to work out. Okay, so we got that section that kind of sticks out all the way around. Now, this is really more just like a decorative piece than anything. I kind of wish I could make it out of a different material than thatch, but that's all I have access to right now is sandstone and thatch. I'm still not that high level. I think I'm, what am I, level 12? Yeah, level 12 so far. So later on, I'll get access to some different materials. I might have a bit of a cooler look to them. But, oh, look at that. Somebody's actually started building down there on the beach. That was not down there earlier today when I was gathering resources. I did a lot of mining of stone out of that area right down there. There's lots of stone that was populating there, but I guess now that somebody's got a little house down there, it's not going to be popping up so much anymore. All right, so we got a close neighbor. I'll have to keep an eye on that, I guess. So I have some more walls and stuff here. I can start doing the second level. There's kind of a little, like, a design thing I want to try doing here, and I don't know that this is going to work. But I'm kind of hoping it will. So if I put on this wall here, I do want to have windows still, but I want to do like this little kind of roof design where there's like another sloping peak here in the middle on the side. How am I going to make this work now? So if I do, I'm going to want outer walls facing out this way. So I think if it crosses this one and it crosses this one, and then I can do a window wall in the middle. I'm not even sure it's going to let me do this. Oh, where's my window walls? I think I must have left them down below. I'm not even sure if it's going to let me do this or not, but I want to kind of experiment with it a little bit. Okay, so again, we'll do... The corners will be like the normal walls like that. I think, want to put maybe a little balcony on this end of the building. So I'm going to do a regular wall here and a regular wall, same thing on this other side. Like that. Like so. And then I'm going to do kind of the same design thing on this side. So, again, I'll have a window in the middle, but I'm going to do regular walls on either side of it. And then back to the corner here. And I'm going to do the same balcony on... Oh, no, I can't do on this side because this is where I have the... this is where I have the stairway up. All right, so we'll forego the balcony on this level. I'm going to do three windows in the middle on this side, I think. We'll just do normal on sort of normal walls here. Okay. So this is going to be the kind of the general layout of this floor. Now, what I want to try and do, and I don't know if it's going to work. I'm sort of hoping you can snap to the end of a roof piece after snapping a piece onto a wall. But I don't know if it's going to snap to this wall or not. So I got it to snap on the inside, but I really want it to snap on the outside. Can I even... I'm not sure this is going to work. Getting snap points like this is tough. I mean, so it's definitely willing to snap on the inside. No. I don't think I'm going to be able to get it to do the angle I want. So out here, what I was hoping to do is have, like the slope that you can see in here. So when it's like this... Sorry, actually, reverse this around. So sloping like this, but going up to, like, a peak. As again, it's really just a design thing more than anything. It's not actually anything functional. But I thought it would look kind of cool. Can I... So I think I'm all... Oh, I'm all out of regular walls. Yeah. I've already burned through all my extra stone. And I'm out of regular walls. So I'm going to put maybe the window walls in here, since it doesn't look like this roof piece is going to work for me. Oh, I do have six more in here. I want to get some torches I can put around that actually hang around, and that's what I really need the coal for. There is an option to do that with the coal. You can make some better torches than what I have now. But I just can't make them. Okay. Fail the place. Uh-oh. Oh, there we go. Okay, I'm going to leave that one open so I can still walk out to the outside if I want for now. And let's just fail the place building piece. There we go. The funny thing is, I'm rotating these ones when they fail to place, and it doesn't actually do anything. It doesn't turn at all. but it lets me place it after I do it. I don't know why. Ah, it's getting pretty dark up here again. I really do need some sort of permanent light source up here, because it does get pretty dark at night. Okay. So that's going to be like that. And then in here, I'm going to have the walls, and then I think a door frame in the middle, and then I'm going to do like a balcony on this edge here. I think that'll look pretty cool. This level, again, will be two floors high, same as it was below. But this is going to take a whole lot more stone mining. There we go. I have no idea... Oh, what is that? Oh, what the... That whole wall didn't connect right. It put it in... Drat. I put that whole corner in with it facing the wrong way. I don't know how I managed to do that. Yep, the whole thing. Both levels. Alright, let's get rid of this. And you can see how the roof is kind of overhanging there. Okay, I did have a couple of those walls left, I think. Oh, I got them right in my inventory already. There we go, that's better. That's what we want to see. Okay. So we've got the start to our humble abode anyway. There is really a lot that needs to be done here still. This is only one level, and it took me so many resources just to do all the foundation for this, and then even just this first layer. But I think overall it's going to look really cool. Ugh. They have all kinds of things they've added into the game too that let you do like interior decorating and things, where like you can have like statues and furniture and carpets and candles and all that kind of stuff. So I think overall it's going to look pretty wild. I do love the view, especially on this side here where you get the view of the two statues. And it is defensible. So not only do they have to come up the tower, but if I can block off that stairway when I log out or something, then that gives me an extra layer of defense there too. Now, the only thing is I can't really see if somebody's attacking the base of this thing while I'm inside the house. And that might present a bit of a defense challenge, but I'm not too worried about it. There doesn't seem to be a lot of raiding going on this particular server, at least not that I've seen. The population has been relatively low also, so even though it's a PvP server, there's not really a whole lot of battling going on. I think I'm going to prep and go out, see if we can find ourselves some coal, so I can do some more permanent lighting. I'm going to have to do a lot more resource gathering, but I can kind of... Oh, I did the same thing on this corner. I'm going to have to do a lot more resource gathering, but once I have everything kind of in place... There we go. And then I can kind of show you what the finished product looks like. The base that I had down below is really just a hut compared to what I'm building up here now. And it was really just kind of a temporary shelter anyway. So overall, looking cool. Hopefully it looks kind of cool from the ground as well. But again, there's still a lot to go, so I'm not too worried about it. All right, I think we're ready for our trip. I've got some meat set up here. I've got a few materials we might need to do a little bit of repairing, although I could use some more of the plant fiber here. just to make sure that we're set for repairs that way, and my clothes. I mean, we can certainly gather it along the way while we're traveling along as well, but I'd really rather not have to stop and do a ton of harvesting. You may also remember, too, that I had built in here a little armorer's bench, and there was a bit of a server issue where they migrated the server, and then everything kind of reset, and I lost everything I had stored up in my chests, and the chests themselves disappeared. My sleeping rolls disappeared, and so did my armorer's bench, and my doors went with it, too. But so I built another one, and then along came a rhino and stuck his head through my wall and attacked me. I was not able to kill him soon enough, and he ended up actually smashing this end of the wall. I've repaired the bottom portion. And he also smashed my armorer's table, which was just chock full of fur and stuff from all the gathering I've been doing. So, unfortunately, I've lost it twice now after having built it. I'm going to build it again a third time, but that next time I think will be topside so that it's not quite as susceptible to issues with monsters that take offense to my little building down here. So let's go out and do a little bit of exploring. I do want to try and find some coal, as I said. And then also, if we come across some metal, that would be awesome as well. I hear another hyena. Gosh. Oh, my goodness. These things are just destroying my shields. Sometimes I feel like the first shield that I was able to make lasted a little bit longer against this stuff. I haven't even gotten away from, like, the visibility of my house yet. I've already had to kill three hyenas. Oh, that looks kind of interesting up there. A little bit strange from a distance. I think I might actually tier that second level in. I kind of want it to look a little bit more tiered. Right, so we could go right here. I wonder what it looks like. There's a building or something right in the middle. Let's try checking it. We'll go this way and see if we can go left. It looked like on the map there was a way we could maybe go left here, but that might actually be up through this. Up this cliff line here. We might not be able to get up there. Oh, jeez. Come on. All right. That one wasn't too bad. He hurt my shield a little bit, but not too terrible. Oh, look at that. My armor's already gotten wrecked. It just destroyed my pants and my gloves and my shoes. I need better armor. All right. There we go. Another one. Come on, hyena. Man. It'll do well for leather, I think. Hide, whatever. Not to mention savory flesh. Savory. I better repair here quickly. I'm going to wind up having to gather resources just to repair as I walk. This is ridiculous. Some money. Alright, so this is just on the other side of the... Oh! That was an arrow. There it is. Alright, so we got an NPC. I wonder if there's actually a village up here. That looks like a cave. I need to get close enough to him. We can take him out before he can hit us too much. Oh, run for it. Oh, no. All right, so I thought I'm going to draw an aggro on something there, but maybe not. I wonder if I can position myself in a way where I can get some shots at that guy with my bow without him hitting me. We got two of them shooting at me now. And they can arc it right over top of there. That's no good. Oh, that hurt. Come on. Those arrows are really brutal. All right, run for it. This isn't working. I don't think I want to go that way. I need some better equipment first. No, we got... Actually, this guy's coming out. If he would come out all by himself, I think I could take him. Although I'm hurt now, and it's not good. Oh, he broke my shield. Come on, get him down. Yes! One down. Let's take his wood. Okay, so with just the two archers left, I might actually be able to get through here now. I think if I can kind of, if I can get up on top of them for a second and then fight the one archer with the other one in between us, then if he tries to shoot at me, he'll end up hitting his buddy, I think. I don't think they can shoot through each other, at least I hope not. All right, so there's just something. I don't know if they can shoot through the rock. I really hope not. No. Okay, so if I can get, if I can get, so there's one guy in between who can play monkey in the middle, get his buddy to shoot him, that might help me out. Rush in here quickly. All right, shoot your buddy. Shoot your friend. Get a little cleave going here now. Oh yeah, these guys are in trouble. Okay, I'm in trouble. All right, whew, we got him down. I didn't think I was gonna be able to do that. If that one guy hadn't chased me out there, then I think this would have been pretty much impossible. Oh, what is this? Torn parchment. What can I do with that? Is there, like, is there something I can examine on that? Info. Nowhere is safe. Nowhere. The drums come every night now, a rhythmic pounding that raises terror in every heartbeat. The Rafari are hunting, and men are their quarry. I used to hear the drums out in the desert groves beyond Zambula, and in that life, I simply thanked the gods that I had wealth and shelter. But see me now, crouched among the boulders, filthy, ragged, and half-starved. My days are a constant scramble for food and water, and my nights are spent huddled in whatever shelter I can find. Soon I will drift off to the half-sleep of the terrified, to dream of filed teeth and wicked cudgels and the haunting beating of those god-cursed drums. I swear I just heard a drum. Ah, that's cool. All right, so we found some kind of a cave. Ooh, it's dark in here. Hello? Anybody home? Hello? What is this? Is this sandstone? Brimstone? What? I don't know what to do with that, but I'm gonna take some. That's cool. That whole thing about gift horses and mounts and stuff. I wonder what the respawn rate is on those guys at the door. Oh, we got another warrior here. And he's got friends. Come on, get him out of here. Primerian Exile? Alright, he's down. I don't think his buddies noticed me, oddly enough, even though I was hacking up their friend. Ah, guy's got a bow, and all he's got are stones. All right, so there's a pretty cool cave down here. This looks big. I don't know whether I'm going to be equipped to come in here. All I came up here for was looking for coal. I have a pretty weak bow. I might be able to get some shots at those guys that are standing on the rampart over there. If I can get them to come over this way, then I'm going to take them out. But I don't know what I'm in for in here. And I don't have a lot of arrows. Nope, there's a guy sitting down below there. I wonder if I can hit him and get him to come up this way. I don't know what the drop like is going to be like here. Nope, did I shoot over him a little bit, I think? For some reason, every second arrow just doesn't seem to go. I'm not sure what the deal is with that. Nope, got him. Oh, I got the attention of his friends, too. Oh, jeez. That wasn't good. Oh, all three of them have arrows. Okay. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe I can do something about this. If I can figure out the angles here. Oh, these are falling short now. So where I was overshooting before, now I'm falling short. I think I hit him. him, her. I think that's, it sounded like a girl. Nice, one down. Ha, take that. Me and my cheap bow. I don't, am I out of arrows? I'm getting low. I should make some more. Ah, I don't have enough stone. I'm three short. Oh, are you kidding? Okay, if I rush in there, I don't know what I'm getting myself into. Can't mine anything in here. I'm gonna have to kind of run out to the entrance here. Hopefully these guys haven't respawned, because that would really suck. Okay. I think I might be able to run up to that bridge there. Oh, jeez. Those guys are good shots. I might be able to run up to that bridge they're on, maybe. I mean, it looks like there might be a way up right over there. If there is, I could get up there and maybe cut them down. But trouble is, I don't know if I'm gonna be running into any other enemies in here. If there's more archers in that cave, it'll pretty much be a suicide run. Alright, let's get these loaded in. I've only got 10 shots. This is not really going to cut it. Ah, I got him. All right, this will work, I think. Oh, jeez. Run for it. Cheese it. Where'd the guy go? All right, there he is. Some sort of a fighter. I can't really see him. It's awfully dark in here. I think he's blocking everything with his knife. That's crazy. There we go. Got him down. Whew. I can see the dark stain spreading out underneath him where I cut him down, but... Okay, so that guy's down. I know I hurt somebody with the bow, so hopefully I can get in on an angle here where I can do the same thing again. Now wait for the arrows to hit the wall. Oh, that's no good. Ah, I hit the wrong button. All right, come on, lady. All right, this lady is actually attacking. The other one just stood there and took all my hits. Oh yeah, now she's not. I wonder if this is lagging. I feel like she should be cutting me down. More wood. Oh, shoot. All right. We're out of here. Run for it. Well, we made it all the way up the mountain pass, so it was just really uneventful. I just ran straight up here. I gathered some branches along the way. I'm hoping I can get enough together that I can put out a campfire, because I could really use some more food. I have plenty of raw meat on me, but I haven't got anything to cook it with. There's another hyena there. It looks like somebody's been building out here. They have a stairway up there, but I wonder if that's just a way to get up to where materials are, or if they're actually building a base up there. I want to kind of run up and take a look. See a base that somebody started over there, too. Oh. Oh, look at that lag. I'm swinging, but I'm not even swinging. Oh, come on. I can't even fight. All right, I got to run. I'm getting some kind of vicious lag. I can't swing my weapon at all. Can't punch. Can't attack. I'm going to die. There we go. Holy, that was weird. I don't know what the deal was, whether it was lag or whether it's just some sort of weird bug, but I could not swing. I was clicking for the life of me and just couldn't swing at him. All right, we lived, though. He didn't do that much damage. Actually, the fact that he didn't do a lot of damage kind of makes me think maybe that was lag. All right. I haven't seen any coal yet. Got more sandy desert up here, though. Oh, cool. There's something else over there, too. All right. Let's see what's at the top of these stairs, whether somebody's already built up here or if this is just some sort of resources or something. Uh-oh. More jackals. Hyenas. Gosh, I gotta figure out what they are. I think they're hyenas. Jackals are more like a dog, I think. did that go? All right. I don't see... There's definitely no coal up here. What are these? Yellow lotus blossom. What? All right. Maybe there's like... Ooh, is there a camp up here? Maybe there's like an alchemy system in this game where you can kind of make stuff, but... I got some yellow lotus blossoms anyway. Nothing else. Maybe I can make my place look pretty. I think that's metal right over there next to that camp. There's another camp here, and I think there might be metal right up ahead of me here, too. All right, if we can get past these hyenas, that actually might be why somebody put a ladder over there or stairs. Maybe. Maybe they set it up so they could have easy access to get up to the metal up here. Hopefully I can gather it with just my feeble little sword. Or, sorry, my feeble little stone pickaxe. Whoa, what is that? I think there's a giant spider over there. I don't think I want to fight that thing. I hate spiders. There's metal up here. I can't get to it, but there's metal up there. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay. I'm thinking if that was a spider, he's probably poisonous, because that's just how my luck runs. I can't get up to that metal. Can I build a stair? Do I have enough for that? We've got a foundation now, and can I snap my stairs on this thing? Yes, I can. Nice. And it's a rock. Are you kidding me? I'm going to mine it up just because I can. All right, if nothing else, I suppose you could come up here and shoot at hyenas. So far, this trip is not proving to be terribly fruitful. Oh, there is people here. I saw the witch doctor. Told me to run off and die. Nice. Yeah, take that. Oh, we got friends. Nice. Okay. One down. My shield's toast. My shield's back. Ah. This guy's got a hammer. I don't like that. This guy's a cook. I want to capture him. And a hyena. Oh, we're just battling everything. Taking on all comers. Whew, we gained a level. Oh, all right, that guy was a cook. Tell me he's got food on him. No, of course he doesn't. Why would he have that? I need food. Okay, I don't know how much is... Hopefully there's not much more in this little village here. I see at least two more guys, by the looks of it. See if we can rush in and get them before they move. Oh, she's got a wicked-looking sword. That thing's got teeth. Literally. She's hitting her friend. That's what I want. Nope, run for it. Cheese it. Run, run, run. Run, run, run. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up the stairs, and then I can go down the other side of the cliff here, so if they follow me up, I can get away. Are you looking for me? Are you looking for me? Ah, nice.
I will feast upon you. Your heart will be eaten.
I really would prefer you don't.
I will drink your blood.
Come on. How many arrows does it take? Am I even hitting him? That's what I want to know. There we go. Oh, I blew his head off with an arrow. How about you? Can we do the same to you now? All right, this worked out really good. I'm really glad I accidentally put that stair there. No ammo. No ammo. Of course we don't have any ammo. Why would we have ammo? All right. I don't have enough sticks or stones to break any bones. All right, we're going to have to do this the hard way. I'm going to gather up just a little bit more health there first, I think, because that's a wicked-looking sword she's got there. All right. Let's drop in and say hello. Oh, I cut her in the leg a little bit. I think it's... Oh, yeah, we got her. It's safe to say she's doing more damage than I am. All right, so she had a little bit of material on her. Nothing good. Tell me we got them all, and I can go loot that village now, and they got something cool for my time. Like, I don't know, food. Because I'm about to start starving to death. I don't see anything here. No, I can't. They got nothing. Nothing. Have you at least got bugs? Tell me you've got bugs. Nothing. All right. Well. I got one bug. I'm going to start starving to death really soon, though. I could eat raw meat, but I'm likely to get poisoned. I don't really want that. What about this? What is the deal with this? With the Black Lotus Spirit for its deadly effect, the Yellow Lotus is known for its ability to cause visions and hallucinations of great import. Those who lose themselves in the low stream can have a difficult path back, but eternal renewal is worth the risk. All right. So, I don't know. It sounds like maybe some kind of healing thing. All right. I need, I'm going to need to run for it, I think. Otherwise, I'm never going to get back in time to try and get some food from my own house. Look at that cool building over there, though. All right. So there is definitely, I did definitely see some metal in the distance, so I do have an idea where it is now. I didn't have any luck finding any coal, though. Well, as you can see, I didn't quite make it. I actually ate a little bit of the raw meat and got food poisoning, just hoping it would give me enough food to get back before I could die. Lo and behold, I got attacked by two hyenas and then the big turtle guy, so I'm going to have to run out and grab my equipment and that brimstone that I had on me before someone else gets it, because I definitely don't want that. We'll come back next time, and maybe we'll go try and head back up there and see if we can get some metal, and then I would like to go further exploring in that cave. I still didn't find any coal that I need, and that's certainly something I'm going to have to get my hands on, so I'm going to call it a wrap for tonight, though. Do some more building, and I'll show you some more of the finished product when we come back next time. Hopefully, I have most of it finished by then. I'm, as always, Katharsus, and I'll see all of you next time.